Welcome to this sharing of some of the latest information on testing some of the South Carolina peach selections that have bacterial spot tolerant fruit. This is new and exciting research, and I'm going to share information from the last two seasons. Initially, we started introducing some of South Carolina's selections, and in 2017, we planted South Carolina 1 and South Carolina 2. As you can calculate, they were like 3 years old in 2020 when we started looking to evaluate the fruit. And later in 2019, we got 4 more selections, namely South Carolina 8, 9, 10 and 11. And since I've been asked to provide information in only 10 minutes, I'll try to make it short today, and we'll share information for the older two selections. Like in South Carolina 1, we evaluated only the fruit in 2020 because mainly we had some cold damage, and additionally the trees were still young to collect information about yield. But our observations suggest that the tree of SC1 ripened on June 1st in 2020, and the fruit was slow to soften on the tree, which is a good thing because the growers can eventually schedule for a longer harvesting period of time without experiencing any deterioration of the fruit. And then fruit size was excellent in 2020. The average fruit size that we got for this selection was 196 grams. Fruit shape was slightly elongated, and this is in comparison with the next selection, SC2, that I'm going to highlight today. The eating quality of SC2 is really excellent. And probably they are siblings with SC2 selection because they kind of were similar in taste as well. But SC1 was slightly more acidic in comparison to SC2. Interestingly, fruit of this selection will soften after a few days at room temperature, and then the fruit will be very pleasant to eat. It will produce a smooth and melting, very juicy texture, really an enjoyment. And you can look at the fruit that we collected in 2020 on this slide. SC2 in 2020 ripened earlier than SC1. We harvested this selection on May 22nd. Fruit size was very consistent, and the eating qualities were excellent. This selection also has melting, juicy, and firm flesh, and very or better balanced sugar to ratio to acids ratio in comparison to SC1. The average Brix for SC2 was 12.1% in 2020. The appearance of this fruit, I shouldn't mention because you can see for yourself, but it is very attractive, especially when on the tree. The shape is more rounded in comparison to SC1, and the blush is covering almost 100% of the skin of this fruit. As I mentioned, we experienced some cold damage during bloom, and we got higher yield from SC1, but a very low yield of SC2 in 2020, and we did not collect those data. What happened in the spring of 2021? Again, we experienced extremely low temperatures very early in the season. On February 15 and 16, the temperatures fell to 15 degrees Fahrenheit. And then Dr. Vinson conducted a study to evaluate all 80, I believe, or over 80 peach cultivars that are at the premises of the station in central Alabama. And he established that early varieties had about 35% bud survivability. Mid-season cultivars had about 28 or lower survivability. And late season ripening cultivars had about 22% live buds. So how those selections compare with the general group of ripening seasons peach cultivars? Like SC2 had about 80% live buds, and you can see on this picture the live buds. And SC1, in contrast, had only about 7% live buds. Those are damaged buds, of course, at the bottom of this slide. And then when we collected data for the yield and fruit quality, we had 5 harvests for SC1 starting on May 28, and the last harvest was conducted on June 11. Among all those 5 harvests, we got the highest number of fruit per tree on June 4th. And the average yield per tree was also registered on June 4th, or in the middle of this season. The mean fruit weight at this point of time was 207 grams for a particular fruit. And for our season totals, we found out that the average number of fruit per tree for SC1 in 2021 was about 14. And the average yield per tree was 2.7 kilograms with an average fruit size of 200.6 grams and soluble solids about 10.7%. So this number tells us that probably we harvested them still a little early, but you know, we were in competition with all the rain that we got this this spring. So here is the fruit of SC1, and you can see that the fruit appeared pretty clean of bacterial spot, probably just some blemishes here and there, but in comparison to our entire collection of peach cultivars, this is a pretty good picture for SC1 in this wet and humid spring and summer season of 2021. And then we collected the data for SC2. In this season, we had 3 harvest dates, started on May 17th and going through the end of May. Here we had our heaviest crop during the last harvest on May 25th, and the highest number of fruit per tree on average that we collected was on the same harvest date. Our largest average fruit size was registered on May 21st. But our season totals in terms of number of fruit per tree were very close, 337, which is very close to completely mature peach tree. So we in general try to retain about 400 fruit per tree. The average yield for SC2 was 84.3 pounds per tree. And we had the mean fruit weight of 137.3 grams. Soluble solids in this season were also kind of lower for SC2. And the next slide, I just wanted to demonstrate the crop load on SC2 in 2021. And you can also look and see some bacterial spot symptoms, but more often on the leaves. And very rarely we have some blemishes on the fruit. So even though our results, our trees are still young and our results, we still consider them preliminary, we would like to look at the performance of those trees as they mature, and we are going to look at them in multiple seasons. But what we can see and kind of conclude for now, they really have a high tolerance to bacterial spot. Their fruit has this high tolerance in comparison to other cultivars in our research station. And they really can provide extremely high paca volume. They have this size consistency, excellent firmness, and excellent eating quality, in addition to their very attractive appearance. I've been told by the breeder that she considered releasing SC1 as a new cultivar for the market, but I don't know. I need to discuss again with her and see how she considers data from this last season. So maybe she just needs to look and evaluate those cultivars for a longer period of time, looking at more spring and winters with damaging cold conditions. I think if you have some questions, I will try to address them, but thank you for your attention today.